It's go time.
Surprise!
Wait!
Pretty good. Girl.
I have a party at my house soon.
Hey, Eagles, welcome back to the broadcast.
I'm so excited for Halloween, aren't you?
Yeah, I am.
Speaking of scary things, let's talk with Vince about our sports for this season.
Hi, Bishop Carroll. I'm Hayes Allen, here to tell you how our fall sports are doing. Starting off with girls tennis, they won City League in all four categories. In the state tournament, the team finished in third place. Brooke Steven and Liza Dugan both placed eighth. And for the second year in a row, Bryn Steven took first place. Next is girls golf, where they just wrapped up the state tournament. Mary Bina placed 24th, Kinsley Montgomery placed 21st, and Bella Jones placed third. The team placed third overall. Now onto cross country. The boys placed first in regionals. Dustin Stevenson placed second, Gunnar Leonard placed fourth, and Luke Meyer placed seventh. The girls placed fourth as a team. Sophia Wendell placed fifth, and Abigail Meyer placed ninth. Both teams went to state this weekend at Rimrock, but as of filming this, we do not have the results. Volleyball just ended their season last weekend, taking second in substate against Andover Central. They ended their year with a record of 26-11. The boys' soccer team won City League this year. They beat Hutch by a score of 8-0 in the first round of the playoffs. In the regional final, they played Salina South on Thursday and suffered a heartbreaking loss in four overtimes. They finished with a record of 10-5-3. Last is football, where as of filming this, their record is 3-5. They enter the first round of the playoffs against May South this Friday. That's all from Bishop Carroll Sports. I'm Hayes Allen, signing off.
It's a bummer we lost to Capen.
Yeah, but I'm glad they could finally win in this century.
Anyways, you ever wish you could switch lives with someone for a day?
Yeah, like with someone from Capen.
Like who?
I'm Karina.
And I'm Andrew.
And let's go to Capen.
We're here! Oh my gosh!
Oh my gosh!
A few minutes later.
How's Andrew? Let's go.
Mr. Blanton's class.
Okay, guys, so I got potassium. I don't know why I picked it. Let's see if we can, like, spell it or something.
Hey, how do you spell potassium? Potassium. Like, what's in bananas?
Okay, guys, so this is my final copy. You know, here for potassium, we got the pink banana. Obviously, banana. And then we got...
Let's get to our morning prayer.
Say, hold up. Wait a minute. Something ain't right.
Hi.
We also have a wall of fame.
What is that?
And we also have a wall of shame.
Oh.
And there are some people who are on the wall of shame so far this year.
What are they? Why do you get put on the wall of shame?
Well, she...
Decade of the Rosary. It's also adoration today, so might as well take you guys. We're really bad about taking you guys down there. Just use the restroom and grab a drink. You can do it on your way down. I would just bring all your stuff because we'll just leave from the chapel. We're just going to spend the whole time in prayer. When we get down there for adoration, though, please kneel.
Oh!
I'll start.
Alright guys, we just finished up here. I thought it was pretty good.
Yeah, it was pretty good, Carol's still up top.
Yeah, so go Eagles, baby.
All right.
See you guys.
Woo! I wonder what lunch tastes like in Smurfsville. I mean, Capen.
Let's head it over to Alex and Caleb with some Lunchroom Interviews Crusader Edition.
I'm Alex.
And I'm Brayer.
And we're back with Lunchroom Interviews
Capen Edition. Who am I here with?
Della.
What is one good thing about Carroll students?
They're never, like, super aggressive when you're around them.
There you go. Who am I here with?
You're here with Armando Villagrana.
Can I get a food review? All
right, man. So what we're going to do is we're going to try out this singular.
What do you think?
Approximately 10 hours later. All
right. That has to be the best thing I've ever tried in my entire life.
Who's your favorite teacher and why?
Mr. Rin, because he's fun to talk to.
Okay. Brock, what is your bench?
He asked
225, but I weigh 130 though.
That's cap.
That's cap. No. That is cap.
I do weigh 130.
Who am I here with?
Corey.
Guess the longest streak that Carroll Sports has ever been.
Oh, yeah.
34 years.
No.
Not?
No.
Wait, what sport is it?
Yes. Yes.
Coach, do you know it?
What's that?
The longest streak that Carroll has ever taken sports.
Oh, it's 44 years.
What? He broke it.
Whoa.
Y'all gotta get that on camera.
Get out of camera.
Get it on camera.
Oh, get him.
Dylan Hoverson. Dylan, why are you at Capen and Hovey at Bishop Carroll?
Because our Resurrection, I went to Resurrection, is a feeder school to Capen, and a lot of my friends are here.
Do you wish you were at Bishop Carroll?
Nope.
Do you think your brother wishes he was at Capen?
He said nope.
Okay, fair. Who am I here with?
Sydney Smith.
What are you going to be for Halloween?
I'm going to be the Lorax.
Paul, what do you think of Carroll people?
I actually think they're pretty chill if you get to know them, but the big rivalry holds us against each other.
Yeah. Who do you think is going to win basketball this year?
Definitely us.
Do you like scary movies?
I'm more into murder mysteries.
Then you would love the fall play. The plot, like gravy thickens.
This year's fall play is The Plot Like Gravy Thickens. Here's what some of my fellow cast members want to tell you about it.
I play Miss Beatrice. She is the main character's older sister. She's very confused. I love her because she's just all over the place, and she has kleptomania, and she's just like very confused all the time, and she's very funny.
I play Hollister, the butler, and a really fun thing about my character is he's very mysterious and sort of, you don't really know what's going on with him.
So the show is actually really cool because we have two casts and two managers, which is a lot easier on our part because we can relate with each other of what we think would be best for this show.
So I find it really fun that we get to have two casts this year for the play. It's awesome because we can get more people involved.
People should come to the show because it's such a fun experience for us as actors, as well as probably seeing it as well. It's very fun, very comedic, and a bunch of jokes.
People should come to the show because it is very different from any other show that we've ever done and really any other show out there. There's a whole lot of audience interaction and a bunch of really funny parts and unexpected things, so.
The show runs November 9th through 11th, with two shows on the 11th. Tickets are $5 and will go on sale the week of the performances. We hope to see you there. Go and see a show.
I cannot wait for the fall play.
Yeah, that's going to be a good one. You know what I also can't wait for?
What?
The Wheel of Punishment.
Welcome to Wheel Unfortunate, everybody. It's your golden boy, Fed Norster. We are being joined by Mr. Ian Sisney. Now, Ian, why are you here?
I'm here today because I lost in Cool Not Cool. My item was not that cool.
Yeah!
Let's go!
No!
Thank you! No.
Oh, it happens to the best of us. Anyways, now let's get to spinning the wheel. Oh, you're getting pelted by water balloons. Oh, man.
Alright guys, so since Ian lost and spun the wheel, he got balloons, water balloons, so we're just going to chuck them at him, don't worry, we'll pick everything up. Alright, ready? 3, 2, 1, go!
Ow! Get off! Ow!
It's cold. I'm all cold and wet. My shoes are wet. I need these for lifetime.
Good afternoon!
What's up, everybody? I'm here, London Pistol, and I'm here with my lovely host,
Swan Jones.
And today, we had the biggest loser from the What's in the Box segment, and they're going to be spinning the wheel.
For Wheel Unfortunate.
That's Wheel Unfortunate, if you couldn't hear him, everybody.
Wheel Unfortunate.
Wheel Unfortunate. All right. Let's bring in these
biggest losers of the day.
Let's bring in these lovely ladies that we have here coming on, spinning the wheel. Come on, ladies. Bring it on in. Hey, hurry up now. Hurry up. Bring it on in. Bring it on in. Bring it on in.
Get
around. That's it. How are you guys doing today?
I'm doing great.
Okay, everybody. Dad, we don't need to know about all that. Let's get on to this wheel spin.
It's not looking good, ladies and gentlemen.
Let's see what they're going to be doing today, and it's going to be eat a whole banana! Do you know what that means?
Yes!
That means you're going to be eating the whole banana. That means peel included. And we're going to be seeing that in the next shot. Alright, we're back from Wheel Unfortunate, and we are with the two biggest losers, and they're going to do their punishment today. Alright. Let's get to it.
Can we cheers?
You wanna eat the whole thing in one go, or are you gonna like?
Kinda... I'm probably gonna take some bites.
You want us
okay.
to?
Okay. Let's just you guys cheers. Pick that however you
Wait,
want.
Wait, 3, 2, 1, cheers. Are we like biting it?
I see you approaching
what else
as you like.
You do? I can't.
Oh.
It doesn't.
Oh, yours looks mad. Oh, yours is brown.
I can't believe I did that.
All right.
That banana was disgusting.
Oh, I kind of liked mine.
Anyways, thank you guys for watching.
I hope everyone has a spooky Halloween weekend.
I'm Avery.
And I'm Bria.
And we'll see ya.